Dear students and my teacher friends, Namaskar. I welcome you to the presentation lecture on the autonomic nervous system, sympathetic nervous system. So here in this lecture we are discussing about the sympathetic nervous system of the autonomic nervous system. Now first of all, the function of autonomic nervous system, what role the autonomic nervous system ANS is playing in our body. So ANS involuntary controls smooth muscle, cardiac muscle and glands. Involuntary meaning we are not aware of it, and ANS is controlling the smooth muscle, means the muscle of our internal body organ, then the muscle of our heart, cardiac muscle, and the muscle of and the secretion of our gland. All this are under the control of ANS, and this way ANS is maintaining the homeostasis in our body. Now here in this lecture we are discussing about how the ANS is different from the somatic nervous system. Then the two part of the ANS, one part sympathetic division or the sympathetic nervous system, and second part parasympathetic nervous system or the parasympathetic division. Then here today in this lecture we are discussing about the visceral reflexes. Then we are also discussing about the neurotransmitter of the ANS. Okay, so starting with the first point, see, function of autonomic nervous system, what role this autonomic nervous system is playing in our body. So autonomic nervous system is a subdivision of the nervous system, and this autonomic nervous system is responsible for regulating activities that maintain the homeostasis. And this activities which are under the control of autonomic nervous system are, for example, secretion of digestive enzyme, it is under the control of autonomic nervous system. Then maintenance of blood pressure, and how this blood pressure is maintained. So it is maintained through the constriction and dilation of blood vessel, artery, vein and the capillaries. So their constriction and dilation is under the control of autonomic nervous system, and this way autonomic nervous system is maintaining the blood pressure in our body. Okay, then the secretion of hormones from various endocrine gland. So endocrine glands are also under the control of autonomic nervous system, and all these activities, all this function are performed by autonomic nervous system, but we are not aware of this activities. And autonomic nervous system is working independently, okay, or we can say it is working autonomously. Okay, so that's why this this nervous system is given the name autonomic nervous system, ANS. Now here you see central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, then in peripheral nervous system, sensory afferent division, motor efferent division. Motor efferent division divided into somatic nervous system, autonomic nervous system. Autonomic nervous system, sympathetic division, parasympathetic division. Now autonomic nervous system sends motor impulses to cardiac muscle, muscle of our heart. Then ANS send nerve impulse to the glands and smooth muscle. Now as the ANS is targeting this organ, and these are the bodily organ present in our body, so that's why this ANS, sometimes also known as the visceral motor system. Now here In this figure, sympathetic nervous system schema is shown. Now the visceral reflex. Okay, now we are discussing the visceral reflex. See, now the ANS asserts control through visceral reflexes. We have already discussed about the somatic reflexes. Okay, somatic reflex we have already discussed, but here in this visceral reflex you will see that instead of affecting a skeletal muscle, this reflex, visceral reflex, affect an organ. So in somatic reflex act on the skeletal muscle and we contract our skeletal muscle. That is somatic reflex. But in visceral reflex, what is happening is visceral reflex directly affecting the organ. Okay, so here in this illustration you will see the visceral reflex, and this visceral reflex, which is shown in the figure, is responsible for the regulation of blood pressure. And all the visceral reflexes of our body follow the similar steps. So what is this visceral reflex? Let's see this. Okay, so here, as you can see, the heart is shown, this one, and this one is the artery they are showing. Now, first point, the receptor detect a change in body. For example, see, in carotid artery, pressure receptors are present. Okay, so when in our body blood pressure rises up, so that time baroreceptors are present in carotid artery, and they detect that the blood pressure has risen up. Okay, so carotid arteries are having baroreceptor, and they detect the rise in a blood pressure. This is the first step, okay, of this visceral reflex. Now in second step, what is happening? Efferent neuron transmit information about this change to the CNS. Okay, see, the glossopharyngeal nerve, this one, relay information that the blood pressure has risen up. This information is relayed to medulla oblongata. Okay, so here you can see the information or the nerve impulse is reaching to the medulla oblongata. Now once the nerve impulse reach to the brain, so the brain centers, they process the information, and now they generate the nerve impulse. So the brain center, they are transmitting a signal along the efferent nerve. So this is the efferent nerve they are showing, and here the efferent nerve is the vagus nerve, and vagus nerve is sending signal to heart pacemaker. Okay, so from brain center, nerve impulse propagate through the vagus nerve, and nerve impulse reaches to the heart pacemaker, and now this pacemaker slows the rate of the heart. Okay, so heart rate slows down. Now fourth point, the effector organ, over here the heart is the effector organ, receives the message and respond. What message the heart has received and how the heart is responding? So the heart rate slows down and the blood pressure is dropping. Okay, so this is the visceral reflex. Okay. over here. See, in this figure also. See, an autonomic reflex arc. Number one. See here, internal carotid artery is shown, this one. Okay, and in this artery, baroreceptors are present. So baroreceptor sense increased blood pressure, that the blood pressure has risen up. Now glossopharyngeal now transmit signal to medulla oblongata that the blood pressure has increased. Now medulla oblongata brain center interpreted, analyze that the blood pressure has increased, and they generate the nerve impulse. That nerve impulse propagate through the vagus nerve. So vagus nerve transmitting inhibitory signal of nerve impulse to the cardiac pacemaker. And now on effector organ, what is the effect? Heart rate decreasing. So now once again the blood pressure normalizes, blood pressure goes down. Okay. So this is how the autonomic reflex arc or the visceral reflex is working. Okay, moving forward. Okay. Now the fourth point we are discussing, third point we have completed, now we are discussing the fourth point. So in the fourth point we are discussing the structure of the autonomic nervous system. See, autonomic motor pathway, both sympathetic and parasympathetic pathway, they differ from somatic motor pathway. And we have already discussed about the somatic motor pathway. The way the somatic motor pathway works, we know that. So once again we are revising that, how the somatic first, let's see how the somatic pathway work, and then we are looking at how the sympathetic motor pathway and how the parasympathetic motor pathway works. So here in the figure, in this illustration, they are showing the mechanism of somatic pathway. So first, see, neurons cell body lies within the CNS. So cell body, here you can see, this is the cell body they are showing. Okay, so cell body is present either in the brain or it is located in the spinal cord. Second thing, this is the axon, and we can see the axon is the myelinated one. So single myelinated axon extend from the brainstem or the spinal cord, and this myelinated axon reaches to skeletal muscle. So here this is the skeletal muscle they are showing, this one. Okay, and up to here this myelinated axon or the fiber is reaching. Now what happened? So this junction, this is the neuromuscular junction, and at neuromuscular junction what happened? From this axon terminal, as you can see, the acetylcholine ACH is released, and this ACH target this muscle. So now from now the nerve impulse, okay, propagate in the plasma membrane, that is the sarcolemma of the muscle fiber. Okay, and we have already discussed the process of muscle contraction. So you know the entire process of muscle contraction, what are the changes that are taking place, what are the changes that are causing, and how the muscle is contracted. You know that, okay? So now we are moving forward. So this one is the somatic motor pathway they are showing. And now here, now in contrast to somatic motor pathway, now in this figure they are showing the autonomic motor pathway. And this autonomic motor pathway involves two neurons, okay? And finally one neuron will reach to the target organ or the effector organ. So what happens in autonomic motor pathway? First, see, a myelinated preganglionic neuron. See, this is the ganglion in the center, this is the ganglion, okay? So the neuron which is present before this ganglion, for example this neuron, is known as preganglionic neuron. And the neuron, this red in color, which is present after the ganglia, this neuron is known as postganglionic neuron. Preganglionic, postganglionic. Before the ganglia, preganglionic. After the ganglia, postganglionic neuron. So myelinated preganglionic neuron extend from the brainstem or the spinal cord to ganglion. So here you can see the soma is present either in brainstem or here in this case it is present in the spinal cord, and this myelinated now fiber extend up to the ganglia. The myelinated now fiber reaches to the ganglia. Now in the ganglia, what happened? So preganglionic neuron synapse with, here it is synapsing with postganglionic neuron. And the axon terminal of preganglionic neuron release the neurotransmitter ACH. So as the ACH is released, and as the ACH is received by this by the receptor or postganglionic neuron, so now the nerve impulse propagate through this postganglionic neuron, and now the nerve impulse finally reaches to the target organ. And at target organ, what happened? So see, the axon of unmyelinated postganglionic neuron extend to the target organ. For example, over here in this case the heart is the target organ, and here the neurotransmitter release varies, okay? So here they are showing the neurotransmitter, and this neurotransmitter is different one. For example, in case of parasympathetic fiber, okay, if parasympathetic fiber are there, so parasympathetic fiber will release ACH. So in parasympathetic nervous system, remember this, okay, postganglionic neurons axon terminal will release ACH, while in case of sympathetic fiber the neurotransmitter is norepinephrine, okay? So in sympathetic nervous system, postganglionic axon terminal, they release norepinephrine. One more figure I would like to show you for this. See, for example, over here, see this one, somatic motor innervation, myelinated fiber, soma is present in spinal cord or in the brainstem, okay? Myelinated fiber reaches directly to the muscle, skeletal muscle. This is the neuromuscular junction, and neurotransmitter is acetylcholine, muscle contraction. Now, in this case, sympathetic motor innervation, soma, is present either in the brain or in the spinal cord. Myelinated nerve fiber, myelinated axon, reaches to the ganglia. In the ganglia, synapse with the soma of postganglionic neuron. Here, neurotransmitter ACH. Now impulse propagate through this unmyelinated postganglionic fiber, and here the axon terminal of postganglionic fiber releasing neurotransmitter norepinephrine, and this norepinephrine accepted by the receptor on the target organ. Now, see parasympathetic motor innervation, how the parasympathetic nervous system works. Cell body present either in brain, spinal cord, okay, myelinated axon fiber reaches into the ganglia. In the ganglia, synapse with post ganglion neuron, and see axon terminal of post ganglion neuron release ACH. Okay, so it is important for us to remember this neurotransmitter at various stages. Okay, in sympathetic nervous system, which one is the neurotransmitter? In sympathetic motor pathway, which are the neurotransmitter? And in parasympathetic motor pathway, which are the neurotransmitters? Now in this figure also, you see motor neuron pathway in the somatic nervous system and autonomic nervous system. Okay, so sympathetic preganglionic neuron they are showing, then in the center autonomic ganglion. So the preganglionic neuron axon terminal release ACH, accepted by postganglionic neuron. Now the nerve impulse propagate, and the postganglionic neuron axon terminal releases NE, norepinephrine. NE effect upon the effector organ or the target organ. Here you see, this we are going to discuss, okay, that how the adrenal gland secrete its hormone. This we will discuss. And here the parasympathetic motor pathway, finally they are showing. Okay, now division of the autonomic nervous system. See, the ANS consists of two division. One is sympathetic division and another one is the parasympathetic division. Now this two division have separate neural pathway and perform different function. However, see, that means their functions are different and their pathways are different, but they often innervate same organ. So many a times they are targeting the same organ, the sympathetic and the parasympathetic nervous system. Now the sympathetic division prepares our body for physical activity. It's also the system that call into play during time of extreme stress. So when our body is under the tension, that time sympathetic division is working. When we are angry, that time. When we are under fear, that time sympathetic nervous system is working. This division of autonomic nervous system, sympathetic nervous system, prepares us for the fight or flee situation. So we are managing to fight or flee from the danger due to the sympathetic nervous system, and the effect of sympathetic division are known as fight or flight reaction. Now in contrast, parasympathetic division work differently. It is having a calming effect on our body. So due to the sympathetic division, sympathetic division enabling us to fight or flight against the danger, okay? And when we are out of the danger, that time the parasympathetic division calms our body. Okay, it is normalizing our body, the parasympathetic division. Okay, now here in the table, they have given us some contrasting characters between the sympathetic and parasympathetic division. So sympathetic division and parasympathetic division. Okay. Now, see, sympathetic division is also known as thoracolumbar division because it arises from the thoracic and lumbar region of the spinal cord. Okay, so here you see, I am showing you this figure, see, figure 15.2, structure of the sympathetic division of the autonomic nervous system. Okay, key solid blue line showing preganglionic neuron, and the dotted line they are showing the postganglionic neurons. And see, this is in the center, this is the as you can see, this is the spinal cord, and from the thoracic region, see, the preganglion innervate the joins the spinal cord. Okay, so we can say in sympathetic motor pathway, the thoracic portion and the lumbar portion of spinal cord is involved. So thoracic region and the lumbar region are the region where the preganglionic neurons cell body joins, or the soma joins. Okay, so this is the entire figure. See. Now, in sympathetic nervous system, sympathetic preganglionic neurons begin with the spinal cord. So, in this figure, first you observe the figure. Okay, sympathetic nervous system they are showing in this figure. See, schematic of the sympathetic nervous system, and this is the key they are given, green color they have used for preganglionic neurons, and red color is used for postganglionic neurons. So, as we can see, this is the thoracic region and this one is the lumbar region of spinal cord. And these are the soma of preganglionic neuron. So this soma of preganglionic neuron, they join in the thoracic region or in the lumbar region of spinal cord. Okay. So all this, see, all this are the, and these are also, okay, these are all preganglionic neurons. In this figure also, see, in the center, this is the spinal cord. Now, in the spinal cord, soma of preganglionic neuron are present. So these are the soma of, this all are the soma of preganglionic neuron, and the myelinated axon or the fiber, this is the, see, these are the myelinated axon or the nerve fiber, and where they are reaching, so they are reaching to the ganglia. Okay, so see here in this figure, this is the sympathetic ganglion they are showing, the sympathetic ganglion, this one sympathetic ganglion. Okay, then this one is sympathetic ganglion. So many sympathetic ganglia together, they are connected with each other and they are forming sympathetic ganglia chain on both the side of the spinal cord. Okay. See. Now, from the cell body, see, as we have discussed this, myelinated fiber, this one, these are all myelinated fiber, and where they are reaching, so they are reaching to the sympathetic ganglia. Okay, and sympathetic ganglia, so where they are present, so they are present, sympathetic ganglia, these are the sympathetic ganglia, these are the all sympathetic ganglia, and they are present on both the side of the spinal cord. Even though in this illustration only the sympathetic ganglia are shown on only on one side they are showing. Now see, sympathetic ganglia, this sympathetic ganglia, this one is the sympathetic ganglia. So sympathetic ganglia, they are present very close to the spinal cord, as you can see in the figure. This is the spinal cord and this is the sympathetic ganglia, and sympathetic ganglia, they are very close to the spinal cord. That's why this preganglionic neuron axon or the fiber are the shorter one. Okay, so this fiber, all this fiber are the shorter one, because the ganglia, sympathetic ganglia, they are close to the spinal cord. That's why. So I am showing you this entire figure. Now, see, in the 9th point, see, now here in this point we are discussing about where this preganglionic neuron are reaching, where they are, up to which level they are reaching. See, preganglionic neuron, their synapse in the first ganglion they encounter, but this is not the case always. Okay, many a times some of them they travel up or down in the synaptic sympathetic ganglia chain to synapse with other ganglia at different level, or some of the preganglionic neuron they pass through the first ganglia to synapse with the other ganglia short distance away. Now what is the meaning of this thing is that, see, for example, this is the preganglionic neuron and it is synapting, it is making a synapse with this sympathetic ganglion. But it is not the case that, for example, let's say this making, okay, this preganglion making synapse with this ganglion. But see here, for example, this one in this case, so this ganglion is present slightly away, or it is possible that, for example, this one it can make synapse with this ganglion. So here it is coming down, or this can synapse with this one. Okay,
बाद में.
सो दिस इज द 9th पॉइंट. नाउ द 10th पॉइंट वी आर डिस्कसिंग. सी, अनमाइलिनेटेड पोस्ट गैंग्लियोनिक फाइबर्स. Unmyelinated postganglionic fiber, they leave the ganglia and this fiber extend up to the target organ, they reach to the target organ, and that's why this postganglionic fibers tend to be very long. Okay, so in this figure, see, first this is the first, you see sympathetic chain ganglia. So this is ganglia, this is ganglia, this is ganglia. So all this ganglia together, they are forming sympathetic chain ganglia. Now generally this preganglionic neuron axon reaches to this, okay, ganglia, sympathetic chain ganglia, and then, for example, see this preganglion neuron, let's say it is synapting, making synapse over here, and this red color, so this red color is the, they have used, okay, so this red color they are showing the post-ganglionic neuron. And post-ganglionic neuron reaches to the target organ. So all these are the target organ, and you see with the red color, these are all post ganglion neuron. Okay, so you see where the post synaptic or the post post ganglionic neuron, where they are making the synapse, that you see. Okay, where they are making the synapse. So, okay. So, post ganglionic fibers are long because they are extending to the target organ. That's why. Now we are discussing organization of sympathetic trunk ganglia. So first of all, in this figure I am showing you, see, this is sympathetic trunk ganglia, and this one is also sympathetic trunk ganglias. So the paired sympathetic trunk ganglia are arranged anterior and lateral to the vertebral column, one on either side. So in the center, we know that in the vertebral column, spinal cord is present. So on either side of vertebral column or spinal cord, we can say the sympathetic chain ganglia are present. Okay. Now their number. Okay. See, typically there are three cervical sympathetic trunk ganglia. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. These three are sympathetic cervical ganglia. 11 to 12. Thoracic ganglia, these are thoracic ganglia, these are all, so 11 to 12 thoracic ganglia, 4 to 5 lumbar, 4 to 5 lumbar ganglia, 4 to 5 sacral, 4 to 5, 4 to 5 sacral ganglia, 1 coccygeal ganglia, this is coccygeal ganglia, this one is coccygeal ganglia. Now what happens? Right and left coccygeal ganglia are fused together, they join together, and usually they are present at the midline. Coccygeal, this one fuse together, and they lie on midline. Okay. See, although the sympathetic trunk ganglia extend inferiorly from the neck, chest and abdomen to the coccyx, They receive preganglionic axon only from the thoracic and lumbar segment of the spinal cord. So here you can see in this region, in cervical region, there is no preganglionic neuron, okay, in sacral and in coccygeal region also there is no preganglionic neuron, but here in the thoracic region and in lumbar region you find that the preganglionic neuron, they are connecting with the spinal cord. Okay. So this was point number 11. Now we are discussing point number 12, sympathetic nervous system. So now we know that sympathetic nervous system is made up of sympathetic chain ganglia on both sides of spinal cord or the vertebral column. Then preganglionic sympathetic fibers, okay, are there. Collateral ganglia are there. Postganglionic sympathetic fibers are there in the sympathetic nervous system. Okay, then sympathetic nervous system also known as thoracolumbar outflow, because the reason is the preganglionic neuron, they connect with spinal cord in the thoracic lumbar region. That's why the sympathetic nervous system also known as thoracolumbar outflow. Okay, so see, because its preganglionic fiber join in the spinal cord only in the thoracic and lumbar region. That's why. Okay. Now chain ganglia. So see, this is chain ganglia, this one is chain ganglia, this one is chain ganglia, this one is, all this are chain ganglia. Okay, now what is there in chain ganglia? So chain ganglia contain cell bodies of many neurons and they are connected serially by nerve fibers extending between them in the trunk. So this is ganglia, this is ganglia, this is ganglia, and they are connected by nerve fiber, and inside many soma or the cell body of neurons are present. Now the point number 14. See, preganglionic sympathetic fiber. So we have already discussed about this. These are the axon of neuron present in the spinal cord, okay, and they sign up directly with the postganglionic neuron in the chain ganglia. See over here. This is preganglion neuron, this one, okay, up to here, and as you can see now, here it is synapsing with post ganglion neuron. Okay, so this is the synapse. Now, this preganglionic sympathetic fiber, they may extend through the chain ganglia to collateral ganglia. So sometimes, for example, if you observe this one is extending up to the collateral ganglia. Okay, so sometimes instead of reaching to the sympathetic ganglion, they are extended and they reach to the collateral ganglion, and in the collateral ganglion they synapse with postganglionic sympathetic fiber, and this post sympathetic fibers they reach to the target organs. So these are the target organs. Okay. See, then the preganglionic fibers of sympathetic nervous system occur only in thoracic and lumbar region that we have seen, and therefore these are often referred to as thoracolumbar outflow that we have discussed. Now, collateral ganglia. First of all, there are three collateral ganglia, and this collateral ganglia, they are situated in abdominal cavity. This ganglia, they are close to origin of arteries. Collateral ganglia, their number is 3, and they are very close to the origin of arteries of the same name. And these 3 collateral ganglia are, number 1, celiac ganglion, second one is the superior mesenteric ganglion, and the third one is the inferior mesenteric ganglion. So in the figure, I am showing you celiac ganglion, then superior mesenteric ganglion, inferior mesenteric ganglion. So these are the 3 collateral ganglion. Okay. Now, postganglionic sympathetic fiber. Now, postganglionic sympathetic fiber are axon of neuron which may have their cell body either in one of chain ganglia or in the collateral ganglia. So, for example, this one, this is the chain ganglia, this is the cell body of postganglionic neuron. So here you can see the cell body of postganglionic neuron is present in sympathetic chain ganglia, but this is not the case always. Here you see, in this case, the postganglionic neuron cell body is present in collateral ganglion. So, point number 16. Point number 17. See, sympathetic nervous system mostly act by releasing 2 neurotransmitters, and these 2 neurotransmitters are adrenaline and noradrenaline at the terminal ending of postganglionic sympathetic fiber. So that means post ganglionic sympathetic fiber axon terminal is releasing either adrenaline or noradrenaline, and that's why this post ganglionic sympathetic fiber are referred as androgenic. Androgenic means similar to adrenal gland, we know same adrenal gland produces adrenaline and noradrenaline, and here the postganglionic sympathetic fiber also releases adrenaline and noradrenaline at the target organ. So in the figure, see here, sympathetic postganglionic neuron releasing any noradrenaline at the target organ, and that's why this post-sympathetic neuron is androgenic. And here you see adrenal gland producing two hormones, epinephrine and norepinephrine. Now, adrenal gland, see, adrenal gland are triangular shaped gland perched on the top of each kidney. So, on the top of kidney, the adrenal gland is present. This adrenal gland play a role in the function of the sympathetic nervous system. They help, they support the function of sympathetic nervous system. And how they are supporting? So, sympathetic preganglionic fiber pass through the outer cortex of the adrenal gland and reach to the center, and center in the center adrenal medulla is there. So when the nerve impulse propagate in the adrenal medulla, so the cell of adrenal medulla, they produce hormone epinephrine and norepinephrine. This epinephrine, norepinephrine enter into the blood stream. Okay, and epinephrine as well as norepinephrine, both of them bind to the receptor of sympathetic effectors, which help prolong the effect of sympathetic response. Now, what is the meaning of this thing? Let me explain. See, over here, sympathetic postganglionic neuron, axon terminal releasing noradrenaline, and this noradrenaline is acting on target organ. Okay. Now, it is not possible that this sympathetic postganglionic neuron is going to continuously produce this noradrenaline. So, extra amount of noradrenaline is required. So, how this is achieved by? So, here you see, this is the sympathetic preganglionic neuron and axon terminal ACH. Now, due to the effect of ACH, the chromaffin cell of adrenal gland, they produce epinephrine and norepinephrine. Epinephrine, norepinephrine hormone enter into the blood vessel, and these two hormones also reach to the same target organ, and this hormone bind with the receptor. Yeah. So this is how the adrenal gland is helping the sympathetic nervous system. Yeah. By producing epinephrine and norepinephrine. Now, sympathetico-adrenal system. Now, what is this sympathetico-adrenal system? See, we know that postganglionic sympathetic fiber are adrenergic. Why they are adrenergic? Because they can, axon terminal of this nerve fiber can release adrenaline or noradrenaline wherever it is required. And we know adrenal gland function same way. Adrenal gland also produce adrenaline, noradrenaline. okay. So adrenaline gland hormone and postganglionic sympathetic fiber together, they function as well integrated system, and this integrated system is known as sympathetic adrenal system. So in this figure also, in this figure, see non-myelinated postganglionic axon, any, and adrenal medulla also producing epinephrine, norepinephrine. So this epinephrine, norepinephrine produced by adrenal medulla is helping the effect of noradrenaline on target organ. Okay, rather we say adrenaline and noradrenaline, they are prolonging the effect of noradrenaline on target organ. So longer time period, the effect of noradrenaline is going to remain on the target organs.